This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, today we'll see one more problem. Analyze the frame shown in figure by slope deflection method and draw the bending moment diagram. Okay, so this is the question. Okay, it is a frame. It has three members: A, B, B, C, C, D. Okay, so in this frame, the sway will occur. Okay, because of the lateral load in the member A, B, and also it is asymmetrical in shape. And also because of non-uniform section, the span AB is of 2i and span CD is of 1.5i. Okay, so because of these three reasons, the sway will occur. So the unknowns are theta B, theta C, and delta. So three unknowns. Okay, the joint equilibrium equations are MBA plus MBC is equal to zero, MCB plus MCD is equal to zero, and one more equation is shear equation. Because of the sway, we are having shear equation. So three unknowns, three equation, so we can solve the problem easily. So the first step is calculation of fixed end moments. Okay, so MF first we are calculating for span AB. So MFAB and MFBA. Okay, the fixed end moment depending upon the loading condition only. So in span AB we are having a point load at center. So the fixed end moment formula is minus WL by 8. Okay, MFAB is minus WL by 8. MFBA is plus WL by 8. Okay. So we know the value of W, L and all. W 8, L is 3. So minus 8 into 3 by 8, we are getting minus 3 kilonewton meter. MFBA is plus 3 kilonewton meter. MFBC next for span BC. Okay, in span BC we are having UDL load. Okay, so the fixed end moment formula is minus WL square by 12. Okay, plus WL square by 12. Okay, MFBC, MFCB minus WL square by 12. W is 9. So 9 into L, length of span BC is 2 meter, so 2 square by 12. So we are getting minus 3 kilonewton meter. MFCB plus 3 kilonewton meter. Then for span CD, in span CD we don't have any loads. Therefore, the fixed end moment values are 0. MFCD and MFBC is equal to 0 because there is no lateral loading on CD. Okay. So after completing the step 1, second step is calculation of slope deflection equation. Okay. So slope deflection, we are having three spans. Okay, so three span, each span having two equations. So totally six equations for span AB, MAB, and MBA. So MAB is equal to slope deflection formula is MFBA, MFAB plus 2EI by L into 2 theta A plus theta B plus 3 delta by L. Okay, so this is slope deflection equation formula. Okay, MFAB value is minus 3 plus 2E into I. I for span AB, the I is 2i. Okay, so 2e into 2i divided by L. L is for span AB 3 meter. Okay, into 2 theta A. So here theta A is 0. Okay, fixed end means slope will be 0. So theta A is 0 plus theta B. Theta B is the unknown. So we have to calculate. So theta B minus. Okay, the frame will move in right side direction. Okay, the supports are at the bottom and the members moves right side. Okay, so the delta is negative. So minus 3 delta, minus 3 delta. We don't know the value of delta. We have to calculate. So minus 3 delta by L. L is nothing but span length of AB only. We are dealing with span AB only. So we have to put the AB length only. So minus 3 delta divided by 3. Okay, finally, the equation MAB is equal to minus 3 plus 4EI by 3 into theta B minus delta. Okay. And second, MBA. MBA is equal to MFBA plus 2EI by L into 2 theta B plus theta A plus 3 delta by L. That is equal to MFBA is plus 3. So 3 plus 4EI. Okay. I value is 2 only. Okay. 2I only for span AB. This is also MBA is nothing but span AB only. So 2E into 2I. So now normally 4EI. Okay. 4EI divided by 3 into 2 theta B. Theta B is the unknown. Okay. So 2 theta B minus theta A is 0, delta becomes minus. Okay, so minus 3 delta by 3. So finally the equation is 3 plus 4EI by 3 into 2 theta B minus delta. Okay. Next for span BC. Okay, so MBC. So for span BC, the MBC is equal to, the formula is MFBC plus 2EI by L into 2 theta B plus theta C plus 3 delta by L. Okay, So this here B, the member BC moves to B dash C dash only. Okay, there is no change in length of BC member. Okay, so the delta, the sway will not affect the member BC. Okay, so the delta is zero for span BC. So M of BC value is minus 3 plus 2 EI. I value is I only. Okay, for span BC, the I is I only. So 2 EI divided by 2. Span length of BC is 2 meter into 2 theta B. So theta B is unknown and theta C also unknown. So 2 theta B plus theta C plus 0. Okay, since delta is equal to 0 for beams only, the sway will occur only in columns. Okay, for beams, it is 0. Okay. So finally, the equation is minus 3 plus EA into 2 theta B plus theta C. Then for MCB, MCB is equal to MFCB plus 2 EA by L into 2 theta C plus theta B plus 3 delta by L. Okay, here also the delta is 0. MFCB value is plus 3 plus 2 EA by 2 into 2 theta C plus theta B. Finally, the equation is 3 plus EA into 2 theta C plus theta B. Then MCD. Okay, MCD is the vertical member. Okay, MCD is equal to M of CD plus 2EI by L into 2 theta C plus theta D plus 3 delta by L. Okay, this is the formula. M of CD, okay, is 0. 2EI into I value is 1.5I. Okay, for span CD, I value is 1.5I. So 2E into 1.5I divided by 2 into 2 theta C. So theta C is unknown. Theta D value is 0. And the delta is negative. Okay, since the movement of the span is in right side, okay, and we have the support at the bottom, so we have to put the delta in negative. So minus 3 delta divided by 2, that is equal to 1.5 EI. okay, 2 cancel, 1.5 EI into 2 theta C minus 3 delta by 2. Okay, next for MDC, M of DC plus 2 EI by L into 2 theta D plus theta C plus 3 delta by L is the formula. M of DC value is 0 plus 2 E into 1.5 I by 2 into theta D is 0, theta C only will come. So theta C minus 3 delta by 2. Okay, here also 2 cancel, 1.5 EI into theta C minus 3 delta by 2. Okay, so next step after completing the slope deflection equation, step 2, step 3 is equilibrium and shear equation. Okay, so equilibrium equation for joint B is MBA plus MBC is equal to 0. We know MBA, MC equations and all. We are substituting that equation and we are solving. Okay, so we will get one more equation, that is 14 theta B minus 4 delta plus 3 theta C is equal to 0. Okay, this is equation number 4. Okay, and we have another joint equilibrium equation at joint C. That is MCB plus MCD is equal to 0. Okay, we know the MCB equation, MCD equations and all. Okay, we are substituting that equations and on solving, we'll get an equation theta B plus 5 theta C minus 2.25 delta is equal to minus 3 divided by EI. Okay, this is equation number 5. Okay, next we have a shear equation. Okay, I already explained the shear equation formula. MAB plus MBA, okay, for span AB, MAB plus MBA, and we are having a load in span AB, okay, acting towards right side direction. So minus P into H divided by LAB plus, then for span CD, okay, MCD plus MDC, okay, we don't have any load in span CD, so no moment will come, okay, because of that load. So only the end moments only will come, MCD plus MDC divided by L. Plus, we are having a load in span AB acting towards right side. So, plus symbol. So, plus P equal to 0. So, this is the formula. So, we know MAB, MBA equations and all. And we are substituting that equation. Okay. P into H. Okay. The load value. P is the load value. Okay. Acting in span AB. And H is the distance. Load into distance. Okay. Normally, we'll get 8 into 1.5. Okay. 8 into 1.5. 8 is the load acting in span AB at the center only. Okay, in span AB, we are having a load 8 kN acting at the center. Okay, span length is 3 meter. The center means 1.5 meter. So 8 into 1.5, 12. Okay. Then plus MCD plus MDC. Okay. Then plus 8. P value is 8. So plus 8 is equal to 0. So on solving this also, we'll get an one more equation. So totally, we are getting 3 equations with 3 unknowns. Okay. So equation 4, equation 5, and finally equation number 6. Okay, so So three equations with three unknowns, that is three unknowns are theta b, theta c and delta. Okay, now we can solve the problems, okay, by using a calculator, okay, by going equation mode. It is easy, okay. We can calculate the unknown theta b, theta c and delta. So delta is 1.42 divided by ei, theta c is minus 0.04 divided by ei, theta b is equal to 0.44148 divided by ei. Okay, so after calculating these unknowns, the next step is final moments. Okay, so MAB is equal to, we are going to substitute theta b, theta c in the slope deflection equation only. Okay, so in MAB we have to substitute theta b delta, so we'll get MAB as minus 4.34 kilonewton meter, MBA as 2.21 kilonewton meter, similarly MBC, MCB and all we can get. Okay, so after getting the moments, next we can draw the bending moment diagrams. Okay, so MAB, okay, this is a, AB is a vertical member, so here we have to fix, okay, which side is above the baseline side and which side is below the baseline side. Okay, so left side of the member is above the baseline, right side of the member is below the baseline. Okay, so MAB is left to right, okay, negative value only, above the baseline. So here we are getting a negative value only, MAB is equal to minus 4.34 only, so that only we'll put in the left side. Okay, can check here the value also, MAB is equal to minus 4.34. okay, MBA positive value. Okay, MBA right to left, okay, positive value above the baseline. We fix that left side of the span is the above the baseline, so it is on left side. Okay, minus 4.34 plus 2.21 and we are connecting this. Similarly here span BC, it is easy, above the baseline, below the baseline la easy. So MBC left to right, negative value above the baseline, so MBC we are getting minus 2.21 only. Okay, so above the baseline side, above the baseline only, okay, minus 2.21. MCB right to left, positive value only, plus 3.3, so above the baseline side. Okay, and MCD, okay, so MCD here, MCD is left to right. Okay, so you please remember, in span AB, MAB is left to right, MBA is right to left. Okay, in here, in span CD, MCD is left to right, MDC is right to left. Okay, so here also we have to fix, okay, here we are fixing the right side of span CD is the above the baseline side and left side of span CD is below the baseline side. Okay, so MCD negative value means above the baseline, that is right side. Okay, we are getting negative value only, MCD is minus 3.3 here, MCD is minus 3.3 kilonewton meter only, so above the baseline here, we fix the right side as the above the baseline, so we are marking a point. Okay, MDC positive value above the baseline side, okay, MDC, but we are getting negative value, so we are marking below the baseline, that is left side of the span CD. Okay, and we are connecting this. Okay, and also we draw the simply supported bending moment diagram. Okay, in span BC we are having a UDL load, so simply supported bending moment formula is WL squared by 8 for span BC. Okay, so 4.5, see, we are drawing parabolic curve, 4.5 kilonewton meter. In span AB we are having a point load, okay, that is acting at the center, so simply supported bending moment formula WL by 4, so 8 into 3 by 4, 6. So we are drawing a bending moment diagram for that also. Okay, is it clear?